Mr. Horton's dedicated his life to fight for us workers.
This epidemic is decimating our nation.
You brought on a new cook?
Woke up in hell, and here I am in paradise.
Welcome to our home.
In our lives for this family. We deserve more.
He is corrupting my entire staff. His cook is attempting some sort of coup.
This review's on the movie Coup. I'm the anger guy. I'm going to tell you like it is. The film Coup is about Floyd, Peter Sarsgaard, who is a genuine opportunist. And that's his best virtue. His least desirable qualities are he uses his street smarts to gain an advantage over innocent and corrupt people. He's also a thief, a liar. He's arrogant to a point that he thought he was always the smartest in the room. He had a behavior that of a child who is always thinking of himself. He is especially a great influencer with people who are impressionable, pliant, or susceptible. All these descriptions are of one person, Floyd, who was seen at the beginning of the film, set in the midst of 1918 influenza, the Spanish flu on Egg Island, where Floyd is taking over a chef's identity to fill the deceased chef's obligation to be a chef at Mr. Horton's, Billy Magnuson's mansion, a meatpacking heir who is a true muckraker since he has moved his family to a large estate, has nothing else to do while this little flu business, as he thought, is over. Floyd's object at first was to survive and have a good time while doing so. As time went on, Floyd didn't know how the help was being treated at the mansion, so he decided to disrupt Mr. Horton's routine just for his own personal payback for treating regular people poorly. The screenplay was different in a way that it was during the Spanish flu, with most events portrayed as real life with a dash of humor. The production was excellent as the set design was 18th century and costumes were simply fashionable for the time, but the mansion was the star because it sold the realistic avenue of the film. Development is hell, but a huge part of Hollywood's process, which I thought this film did a great in that department. With the use of a grain of salt, a dash of humor, and suspense added for realism, the entertainment value was acceptable. The acting was a hard A, because I actually believe the actors were real with their own faults and mannerisms. The photography was good, except some parts during nighttime. As an audience member, I think I wanted to know more about the character because there weren't that many. The film Coup did have a good flow because the director had just enough ingredients of wit, conflict, and excitement throughout the film to keep my interest. The ending was not what I expected, but I know in real life, if you have been rich most of your existence, a person will do anything, I mean whatever it takes, to keep their present lifestyle. Out of an alphabetic score, I give the film Coup a B-. Peter Sarsgaard always gives 100% in his work, even in some of his films that are, in my opinion, just average, but I respect him because of his great work ethic. Appreciate you viewing and value your comments.